but there's now four individuals that want to talk about the City Park bathhouse that if you're not able to be at the work session tonight, we did schedule the upcoming work session that we will have a report from the Parks Director, and there'll be an opportunity for the new council to chime in on a decision that was made by the former council in terms of pursuing that project and moving forward. I just want to be clear that there is an opportunity with this council to change that decision and rescind that the vote that already took place, not continue. That's what's going to happen. So we're going to have an opportunity for the staff to present what has happened and how we reached that point, and we'll have an opportunity for council to also be involved with that discussion. So that doesn't mean that we don't want to take your testimony tonight, but I want you to be aware that that already will be taking place. So I'd like to invite Elvin Rivera, and just for those of you that might not have given testimony before, we allow six individuals to give public testimony for a regular city council meeting, and we allow 5 minutes, and there is some stipulations that go along with that, but I think pretty much everybody here tonight already knows those. So Dr. Rivera, welcome, and we have 5 minutes.
Thank you very much, sir. Is it on then? Okay. Thank you very much. Distinguished City Council members, my name is Dr. Alvin Rivera. I'm a resident of Pueblo. I wish to welcome the new City Council members, especially the new Councilwoman Lori Winter. That's with two N's. This council is desperately in need of a woman with leadership skills as those of Councilwoman Ms. Winter. My topic this evening is about correcting an ill-advised city council decision regarding the Pueblo City Parks bathhouse that is slated to be slated for demolition and the building of a new structure, as you all are familiar with. I have visited firsthand in the facility, so I have some knowledge there. Initially, I seriously questioned the need to destroy this structure. It is made of sturdy materials and can easily continue to serve Pueblo swimmers for many years to come. There are some structural changes that are needed to be made to accommodate the ADA, that's Disabilities Act requirements. However, those changes can easily be made without the necessity to destroy the existing structure. Further, even if the building were destroyed, the proposed costs are so far out of line, it raises questions concerning whether or not city officials are getting quality value for taxpayer dollars by constructing a new facility. For example, according to the proposed budget, I believe there are cost overruns in the thousands of dollars for electrical and plumbing categories, similar cost overruns for security mesh, and that has to do with hollow metal framing, also flooring, it's epoxy flooring, and the exterior painting, it's a good graffiti painting. Moreover, the five companies bidding on the project are recognizable names, and that too is troubling. The city needs to cast a wider net to get new and different contractors for this city project, as well as other city projects in the future. In my visit of the existing bathhouse building, I was outraged to see a city building that was not just dirty, it was filthy. It is all too apparent that the filth buildup was an accumulation of years of chronic neglect. Frankly, I was embarrassed for the city and the city officials escorting us through the building. The Director of Parks and Recreation needs to set different priorities when it comes to cleaning all similar types of structures that may be vacant to clean all similar types of structures that may be vacant for a period of months or due to weather considerations or changing seasons or even pending work of existing structures. And finally, my personal recommendation is to rethink the need to destroy this facility, because it is not necessary. I think the structure is sound. Secondly, it is, I believe, unwise to use government resources for the runaway high costs being proposed. For example, an average cost of the five bids was over $519,000 and change versus an estimated cost of $200,000 to keep the existing structure with various updated improvements. And three, finally, those improvements can be done for less than one-fourth of the cost. The existing structure could be given a thorough cleaning, painting, and reconfiguration to make it suitable for ADA requirements, including any issues of processing and swimming patrons upon entry and exit of the facility. And thank you very much. I did have an opportunity to hear the discussion earlier, at least in part, and I thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, for hearing my additional suggestions.